Hi guys, what's going on? I hope everyone is safe and sound. So today I'm gonna discuss about a card which was trash talked to death, the GTX 1650 non-super.
This business is not okay. This needs to stop now. This is cancer. This is so much cancer that I can feel the tumors growing on my back.
And try to defend its existence in the GPU segment. Or in short, I'll be talking about the true purpose of the card and for whom it was really made. Now, before proceeding into the video, there are two things I want to make clear. First, this video is an informative video, which point out the only situation / scenario where this card is viable. And second, I am in no way recommending this 1650 if you are building a brand new PC. Instead, go for its big brother, the 1650 Super, which provides much better performance and value for the price point. Now into the video. First, a background check of the card. So the GTX 1650 was launched back on 23rd April 2019 and was based upon the new Turing architecture. Had a base clock speed of 1485 MHz, boost clock of 1665 MHz, a memory bandwidth of 12 GB/s, 4 GB of GDDR5 VRAM, and a TDP of 75 watts only. It came at a price point of ₹12,999. Or $145 internationally, but again, prices vary from country to country. Now the card performed okay for 1080p resolution and got around 17 to 20% better performance than the old popular budget card, that is the 1050 Ti. And for the people who are wondering how many FPS does that 20% gives, it's around 15 FPS average more than the 1050 Ti. Now the card has potential, but the price point at which it came, one can buy a new RX 570, which is an 2-year-old AMD card which not only outperformed the 1650 but also came with 8 GB of GDDR5 VRAM, which in reality credited the 1650 a bad value for the money card. And though the card was based upon the Turing architecture, it didn't have the Turing goodies like the Turing video encoder, which is great for streaming, for recording gameplay footages. No, it didn't even have that, but rather have the old Pascal-based video encoder. Now, I am starting to trash talk, but here is the catch. The 1650 is a very power-efficient card, which do not need an external power connector, unlike the RX 570, and can derive all the power it needs from the PCIe slots, so which is basically plug in and play after you download all the necessary drivers. The card is marketed to work with at least 300 watt PSU, but you can get away with 250 watts if you are at it. This makes the card ideal for pre-built systems which do not have fancy PSUs with any additional 6 or 8 pin power connectors like the Dell Optiplexes, OEM systems, APU builds, office PCs, or the PC that your parents brought 2 years ago for writing essay and now you want to pop some demon skulls in Doom Eternal. This card is perfect for that and is the only reason it's still around. The 1650 plays most games at 1080p with decent frames and perfect for those who want to upgrade for a better experience but do not have a branded PSU with extra connectors or want to change much of their PC parts. Keep in mind, there are also low profile 1650 from Zotac, MSI, which can universally fit in any cram cases or small form factor cases like Mini ITX or so. And if you're going for this card, watch out for high-end custom cards like the Asus Strix version, which needs a power connector, a 6-pin power connector. So yeah, be careful what you pick. So yeah, that's it. That's the only reason it even exists in market. And now it comes with the faster GDDR6 VRAM, which gives you average of 3 FPS more in titles. Cheers. Now here is a note, if you are on a budget but want an efficient card, go with an used 1050 Ti, preferably the small single fan models from Palette or Zotac. It will give you better value than the 1650, but if you want the max frame possible without changing much of your system, 1650 it is. Again, like I said earlier, if you are building a new PC, do not buy a 1650, instead go with 1650 Super. Thanks for sticking to the end of the video. Like this video if you found it useful and share your thoughts about this special GPU in the comment section. And subscribe to the Fallen Glass for more of such videos. Until then, stay happy and stay awesome.